27th, 2020. Hello everybody, this is Sergei Baklikov. I keep uploading my video blog on YouTube. Now in St. Petersburg, Russia, this is the very beginning or the very end of Nevsky Prospect. Depends on how you look at this. Well, if historically this is the very beginning of Nevsky Prospect, Nevsky Avenue, this is the square of Alexander Nevsky. That's the great prince of Novgorod lands, and you know, back then in 13th century, in old Russia, old Rus, Alexander Nevsky was one of the most significant persons. It's really pretty hard to overvalue his role in the history of Russia, when he saved Russia in a moment when it was attacked from three sides at once. You know, back then, Novgorod lands was the basement of Russia. You know, now it's Veliky Novgorod, located in 200 kilometers from here. This is St. Petersburg, the area around its Leningrad region. But back then, it all was the Novgorod lands in a moment when St. Petersburg not even existed. It was almost 500 years before St. Petersburg. So that's why so many things here in St. Petersburg dedicated to Nevsky. And you know, right behind him, there is the oldest and still the biggest monastery. It's St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Monastery, Alexander Nevsky Lavra. And you know, exactly the monks of St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Lavra, they started to construct a Nevsky Prospect from this side, and then from another side they started to construct the new Nevsky. So that's why still now they call this part as an old Nevsky, and that one as the new Nevsky, and they meet at the square of revolt or square of uprising. And that's why there is a curve, actually, because they started making this not equally. Yet in like 19th century they wanted to correct it, but yet back then they didn't understand that it's not going to be efficient. Well, so is now even more than that. Well, today actually I came to look at the St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Lavra. Let's go there. St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Lavra, it's the very first, the oldest and the biggest monastery on the territory of St. Petersburg. It was based just 7 years after the city itself was founded. The city founded in 1703, so that's why when you're in St. Petersburg you can see a lot of people with a t-shirts with 1703. That's actually the people shows their respect to their cities, their city. This monastery by decree of Peter the Great was founded in 1710. Well, from one side it is in the very beginning of Nevsky Prospect, from another side it's from the side of Neva River, absolutely a beautiful place, and that's actually where it's supposed to be one of the greatest battles in the history of Russia, where Alexander Nevsky participated, actually, Neva Battle, the great Neva Battle. And this is a huge complex. It is started to be constructed by the project of an Italian architect, Domenico Trezzini. Domenico Trezzini actually works on many projects in St. Petersburg. And then after his death, the project continued Ivan Starov. You know, on the territory of Alexander Nevsky Lavra, here is several cemeteries where are buried significant people. Enough to say that behind this wall there is the graveyards of Dostoevsky, Fyodor Dostoevsky, and Pyotr Tchaikovsky. I guess I don't have to tell you who they are, the writer and composer, actually. So this is a whole ensemble of an Orthodox Christianity religious constructions like this. You know, even this is the church, Nadvratnaya Church, what means above the gates. And that's like one of the main entrances here. Yeah, from here now we can see the beginning of Nevsky, the Nevsky perspective. Actually, that's how it used to be called, Nevskaya perspektiva. Getting inside, so the cemeteries are as from here as from this side. And there we already can see the dome of the main dominant church, the yellow one, that's Trinity Cathedral. I have a separate video I already filmed here, Necropolis of Art Masters. That's where are buried Tchaikovsky, Dostoevsky, Mikhail Glinka, Dergamyshsky, Borodin, and more and more. But now, because of frigging coronavirus, unfortunately it's closed. But you can check it out. You can check it out. Just the video called Necropolis of Art Masters. This is the river which used to be called back then Черная речка, Black River. Now it's called Река Монастырка, from the words monastery. And exactly in a place where it starts from Neva River, they are on a corner organized this wonderful church, monastery, and all the churches. It looks real gorgeous. A little bit earlier I told you these parts of Neva River supposed to be as an exact place where famous battle on Neva River happened, featuring Alexander Nevsky as the leader from Russian sides. That's actually where from he's got his nickname. He is Alexander Yaroslavovich, means the son of Yaroslav. After this battle, he gets into the history as Alexander Nevsky. Back then, at the 15th of July 1240, he fought against Swedish, Norwegian, and Finnish armies and won. You know, the battle really was on Neva River, but a little more down Neva, not far from Ust-Ižora village. So it's more like a legend about the battle being exactly here. However, it never refutes that this place is definitely was a beautiful point to found the monastery in the frames of St. Petersburg. St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Lavra. Now it is just a beautiful, beautiful park. 2000 years since Christmas. The caption there. Also, the cemetery right next to Trinity Cathedral, where are buried a lot of archimandrites of St. Trinity Alexander Nevsky Lavra. It doesn't feel like weird here. Pretty quiet. The birds are singing. Cutting the lawns. As I told you, this project started an Italian architect, Domenico Trezzini. He saw this monastery as the symmetrical complex of stone buildings. In the same time, it was constructed as a forepost on the southeast of the city of St. Petersburg. Because back then, the wars were happening all the time, and the main threat was from the side of Sweden. Many probably knows about a long-lasting, back in those days, long-lasting 20 years Northern War. That's the war between Russia and Sweden. While they are constructed the main building of monastery, there appeared also small buildings for workers and for the staff. And also they managed a garden in order to plant the food for the staff. Then later here appears forge, carpentry workshop, horse stall, barnyards, and then later the schools for monks and stuff like that. After the death of Domenico Trezzini, the development of monastery of this Lavra continued a Russian architect, Ivan Starov, and it was completely finalized only to the beginning of 20th century. In this final view as a huge monastery complex with the Trinity Cathedral as the main dominant building. Here is also the Annunciation Church, Feodorovskaya Church, Nadvratnaya. Well, we already saw that above the gates church. Also cemetery churches, the Church of St. Lazarus, Tikhvinskaya Church and Nikolskoya Church. Here is also Bishop's House, southern and northern corpses with towers, consistory and cemetery office. And here, at one of the walls of Alexander Nevsky Lavra, the street art with an image of Sergei Bodrov, a Russian actor who played the role of Danilo Bogrov from one of the most popular and significant epoch Russian movies, Brother, the first part, which is completely was filmed in St. Petersburg. Unfortunately, he died in 2002 in a bad accident in the mountains of Caucasus. They still never found him, but it's absolutely obvious that he died somewhere there. Okay, dudes, I hope you enjoyed the video. Enjoy it enough to comment, like, and subscribe if you're not yet. Stay tuned, keep watching, and F the coronavirus. You know, I just don't want to pronounce this word now after filming Lavra, you know, an Orthodox Lavra. So F the coronavirus. See you.